Hello, Janina. Kwento mo muna sa amin. You're a full-time host. You're a content creator. Siyempre, nung una, may side hustle ka na iba. Paano mo minamanage yung time mo? As a host, content creator, Instagram celebrity, di ba?
Lahat na. Iba-iba.
All around.
Kung anong nandyan tatanggapin. So I guess, let's go back na lang in general. Ano ba? Paano ba nag-start tong lahat? Honestly, I knew na parang gusto ko talagang mag-host. I guess madaldal din ako. I guess parang in a way, this is also parang sa mga nakikinig na parang gustong i-pursue yun. Why not? Diba? So, I started out in terms of... Okay, ang dami. Wait lang. Okay, let's get back to the very beginning. I was a kiddie host talaga for Kids TV. And it started before when I was, ano pa, parang modeling as a kiddie model for Barbie. Because of that field, dun namin, we were introduced to the hosting field since it's parang tied together naman. Alam mo yung mga, oh, ito, nag-model ka, try mo naman mag-host. So that's how I became a kiddie host, not knowing na it could be such a fun, fruitful, and fulfilling career. And with that, parang I sort of just, there were opportunities na nandun, and tinanggap ko naman siya, try lang, diba, ganun naman lagi yon. And then, from Kids TV, I couldn't be a kid forever naman, diba? So I had an opportunity to be a junior journalist naman for Newswatch, which was on RPN9. So I was there actually as a junior reporter, as a teen reporter, and a mainstay lifestyle reporter for 5 years then. Tumagal din while I was still studying in high school and college, early college. So that was on RPN9. And for me, it felt like an extracurricular activity. And at the same time, parang ang saya na... nasa real world ka na rin.
And you get to meet a lot of people.
You meet so many people. I think that's really the best thing. Aside from the other people, parang, well, yeah, aside from, syempre, kumikita ka na rin at the same time. Pero ang maganda talaga dun is that you expand your network too. So, at the same time, parang, ayoko kasing mabore. That was me. I hate getting bored. Tapos parang ang saya lang to just be kept engaged with all these activities outside school. So there was also an opportunity to do to be a radio jock, a junior jock on Magic. So in a way ngayon podcasting na, diba? Also with UAAP naman, I was in college. Oh no, that was after college. I was not like a courtside reporter.
No, school lang ano po.
Ateneo ako, pero nung nag UAAP na ako, basically it was for a show called Upfront. Sobrang bet talaga ni God. Parang inantan yung graduate ako to make sure. Alam na kasi niya, oh, busy ka na girl, tsaka ka na mag UAAP.
Upfront, tapos ngayon so, yung podcast mo, Rise
yes,
Up.
Kaya Rise Up naman. Yes. Oh my gosh. So yun, Upfront. Oh, nga, puro up na. Upfront at the UAAP. And naging parang nag-NCAA din kami. So that was after college. And then during parang nagka-Chinoy TV din, that was on ANC. So these opportunities, they don't just come knocking at your door then, diba? Sometimes you have to be engaged outside in the real world. Tsaka ka magkakaroon ng mga opportunities na ganyan. It's because of the people you meet also. And it's because of the quality and the work that you give. Yun din. So that's hosting. And when it comes to content creation naman, it was kind of there all along. You know how social media was there naman ever since. And I kind of just posted lang mga pictures ko, outfit pictures, you know, the usual.
Mga OOTD, yun yung uso ngayon
mga ganun. Hanggang ngayon, uso pa rin siya, diba? So, yun, dinaanan ko yung mga, what do you call that? Parang I went through the phase na may mga filter pa na medyo cringe na ngayon, yung may mga grid pa.
Anong favorite filter na ginagamit mo noon?
Oh my gosh, noon, hindi ko alam, Valencia, naalala ko. Oh my gosh, diba? Sobrang hindi na uso yan ngayon. Parang mas maganda na ngayon, raw and real. So, yun, parang I just kept posting, and at the same time, I would also post about my work, which was primarily hosting. So parang that made sense to me to keep around. Kasi in a way, that was kind of like my online portfolio. So I kept posting on Instagram, Facebook, yung mga online platforms ko. And then nalalaman ko na lang na parang, oh, there was a demand for parang sponsored posts in a way, but also tied to my lifestyle. So it's like a win-win. It starts with getting free merch or free stuff, like free clothes. clouds. Mm-hmm. And then biglang magkakaroon ka na lang ng pitch or ng proposal na it's a paid campaign. So it actually, that's how it started as a kind of like another job or career, which now is so much more prevalent. I mean, hindi na ngayon stranger yung, hindi na ngayon different yung term na content creation sa atin. Mm-hmm. Alam na natin yan, di ba? But it's knowing how to monetize it more, which is, I guess, what I'm here for.
Paano mo minamanage yung time mo nung mga panahon na
you're
in school? Nagkaroon ka ba ng regular job sa office?
Parang, no.
Hindi mo na-try eh, no?
Yeah, na-try ko siya sa internship ko. And yung internship ko was ano pa for Fox Sports. So ano pa siya, parang ang saya na ng office talaga yun na yun. Na communication office na siya. Yeah, sa BGC. Pero even, I mean, I loved what I did and my boss there when I was an intern was so cool. Ang saya, pero parang hindi pa rin for me yun. Parang mas gusto ko yung hindi monotonous na laging nasa office. Gusto ko yung iba-iba palagi. Iba-iba nakakausap ko. Iba-iba yung brands that I work with. It's so much more fun for me that way. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so yun.
Hawak mo oras
managing,
mo.
Yeah, in terms of managing my time, yun. Hawak ko oras ko. Parang I never had like another manager. Ang joke naman sa house is that God is my manager and mom is my handler.
Wala kang manager. Okay, yeah.
God is my manager because kung anong dumating, yun ang minamanage namin ni handler, which is mommy. Mama Sally. So she's kind of like there helping and assisting me because it's also what she wants to do. Mm. And I think also, parang mas ano lang eh, mas gets namin yung isa't isa. And I think at the same time, I know that she's always there for my best interest, mm-mm, which is very reassuring for me.
Yun ang secret weapon mo, si Mami. Si Mami Sally. Yun ang secret weapon ni Tanina.
Yes, maraming nakakakilala na sa kanya because of me. So yun, minsan ang cute. Minsan pag nagpapadala ng gifts yung ibang agencies, it's for me and mom. So kakatuwa lang. Oh. Alina.